In this video, we are going to discuss photo frames problem. This problem is from Starlink mock exam silver division. There are n photos, can be at most 10,000, and we have to put them on a wall row by row. We don't change the order of the photos, and we want to minimize the space between any two photos or the space in one side of the wall. So in the sample input, there are 5 photos and their width are 3, 4, 7, 4 and 1. We can put them in the rows in any way without changing the order. For example, we can put the first 2 frames on the first row. Here, 3 and 4, their width. In that case, because the length of the wall is 10, the space will be 1, the maximum space here. 3 plus 7 is 3 plus 4 is 7. So the remaining space is 3. Because there are only 2 photos, we divide them into 3 and the maximum one is 1. We can put the third photo on the second row and space will be here in one side, will be 2. We cannot make it smaller than this one if we have only third photo on the row. Then we can put last 2 photos on the third row. And the total length is 5, the remaining space is 5, and we have to divide it into 3 parts, so it could be 1, 2, and 2. So here the answer is 2, because the large 2 here, 2 here, and another 2 here. You may put the photos in different rows. For example, 3 can be alone in the first one, on the second one, but it will change the space, it will just increase the space. So this is the one of the solutions to that problem. So we can put solve that problem. Because n is up to 10,000, we can try all possible ways. If one photo is alone in the row, or it is together with the previous one, and so on. So this is a kind of dynamic programming problem. So we make the incremental solution. We solve if we have only one photo, what is the solution? If we have 2 photos, what is the solution? When we have 3 photos, what is the solution? And we use the previous partial sum, partial solutions. Let's try it here. I just write the width of the photos directly here. 3, 4. Have some more space. 7, 4, and 1. If we don't have any photo, the answer is 0. So I write here 0. If we have only the first photo, 3, what is the solution? So if we have only one photo, the total length is 10 until here. And the width of that photo is 3. So the remaining space is 10 minus 3 is 7. And we have to divide it into 2 pieces because there is only one photo here. So 7 over 2. And we take the scale function here is 4. So the space in one side will be 4, and space on the other side will be 3. This is how we calculate the temp result here. So the answer will be here 4. If we have only one photo, the answer will be 4. Let's calculate the best result if we have 2 photos. Here we make it like that. If I have this photo alone in the second row. So suppose that I put the first one on the first row, and now I put the second one on the second row. So it could be like that. We should take the maximum of the previous result. It is 4 here. and the cost of the current row. If I have only four on the row, in that row, so here on the left side, I will have the space three, and on the right side, I will have the space three. So the cost of the last row is three, but I have another cost here, four, in the previous one. So I should have the maximum one. This is one possibility if that photo is alone on the new row. But I can put them together maybe. If their width is not larger than L, not larger than 10, I can put them together. So if I have last two photos, what is the cost? So the cost would be like that. Maximum of the previous cost, it is zero here. And the new cost here. Here instead of four, if we have three and four here. If we have two photos, what is the cost? Here we have three. And here we have four. This time, the remaining space will be 10 minus 7, it is 3. And number of the space here will be, number of space, let's say it, will be 3. Because there are two photos, and we will have 1, 2, 3 space. And here we calculate the cost. The cost will be space over number of space. This is total space here. And we have the sale function here always. So this 3 over 3 is 1. So the cost will be here 1. So we have to take maximum of 0 and 1. We have only two photos, and those are two options. Then we get minimum of those two values. So it could be 4 from here and 1 from here. So 1 is better. So the if we have only two photos, the result will be 1 here. And this is the configuration. We have 3 and 4 together. We continue to the end of the photos, and here we will get the result. Let's make that 1. If I have 7 alone, the result will be this cost 1. And the cost, if we have only 7 on the last row. So the remaining space will be 3. We divide it by 2, so it will be 2. This is one case. If we have 7 and previous one together, but their sum is larger than 10, so we cannot have another one. So for 7, this is on the case. And the cost will be here, 2. We get the maximum of them. So we have those two books together and 7 alone. Because of 7 here, we have 2. So this is the case actually, until here. And we try for 4. If I put this one alone, the cost will be maximum of the previous result and the cost of this one. If I have 4 alone here, so 10 minus 4 is 6. There will be 2 spaces. 6 over 2 is 3. This is one case. Then I try, if I put 4 together with 7, I cannot, because their sum is larger than 10. So for that one, the result is 3. How did I get 3 here? Okay, this 4 is alone. And here we try that one. If I put that one alone, if I don't have this one, the result will be 3. Then it would be the result of the previous one. And if I have 1 alone, the remaining space 9, divided by 2, it is 5. If last photo is alone, the result would be 5. Then I try, if I put last two photo together, their sum is 5, smaller than 10, it could be. So in that case, the result will be, I put them together, then I get the previous result always, 2. And the cost, if I got them together, so it is 5. The remaining space is 5. There are two photos. I divide it by 2. 2.53. And then I will get minimum of those values. So here we have 5, here we have 3, and the result is 3. So this is the result. If I have all those photos, this is the minimum space in one of the rows in the best configuration. So what is the time complexity of that solution? So there are n photos, and for each photo, we try it alone with previous one, with the previous one, because L is too big, 100,000, it is possible we can place all the photos on one row. So it could be n times n. So time complexity of that solution is quadratic. But this is good for 10,000. So let's see the code. This is my implementation of that algorithm. So we got the, in the input, we got them into photos vector. Then in the DP vector, I initialized to int max at the beginning, all of them are infinitive. And the first one is all zero. Because here, if there is no photo, the result is zero. This is our starting position. And then in each row, we try if there is only one photo, if there are two photos, three photos, and so on. But we must check that the total length is not larger than L. And for each position, we keep the minimum of that. We calculate the temporary result, and then we keep the minimum of them here. We keep them at the end, we keep the minimum of them. For each one, that maximum is the cost of that one and the previous one. And we make it, here. And when we finish those nested for loops at the end, in the last position of the dynamic programming vector, we have the solution.